need is actually the most important need. And where we want to start is being able to make sure that that individual has a job to go to in the morning and comes back from work and he's tired, goes home to sleep. We do not want to leave people out there wanting to do something other than that. Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Mann.
You know, many people have said to me that they find it offensive that Reverend Brown would race to every scene of the latest victim, the latest homicide, and exploit the pain and suffering of the grieving families. I think what we need to do is focus on the solutions, and as your mayor, I have implemented a number of things that have impacted on crime and violence in our city and have driven it down. We have installed cameras across the city. We have also hired 20 new police officers, and we are about to hire 10 more. We have executed or implemented community policing. Our officers are mentoring our young people and teaching them how to walk the straight and narrow. So we need to teach our young people how to live and how to stay away from negative behavior that will affect them for their entire lives, rather than exploiting the pain and suffering of the families that have been impacted by these acts of violence. But we have driven down the crime, and we will continue to aggressively go after these violent individuals so that our city will continue to be safe.
Thank you. Next question. What can you do to fight racism in Plainfield, New Jersey? Reverend Brown.
Let me just say one thing, that I don't export families in town, that I was on the scene of one murder victim. That's because the mother called me to come have prayer with her family. That was just one family. And the reason they called me is because nobody else shows up. But one of the reasons, in reference to, what was the question? I'm sorry. I was so taken back by the outrageous statement that Mayor Matt just made. I can't believe that he just said that.
What would you do to fight racism in
Well, one of the things that I would do to fight racism in our town is to, you know, to teach our young people, you know, that everybody is equal, that everybody matters, that it doesn't matter what color you are, it doesn't matter your religion, it doesn't matter your sexual orientation, that everybody should be treated with love. And I think it starts in the home, that we got to teach our young people, you know, that everybody matters and everybody is equal.
Thank you. Dr. Davis, Basie.
Well, we have to be able to live together as a human race. The color is never important. It's the person you're telling me that is important. Plainfield is changing very much from what it used to be. They are newcomers, and they will continue to be newcomers. And we must have open hands welcoming people and teaching them how to become part of this Plainfield family. We cannot make people to feel different. We must welcome them into our homes, and we must make them know that they are very welcome in Plainfield. Thank you.
Mr. Matt.
My rallying cry, what you've heard from me ever since I took office, is one Plainfield, one future. We live in a very diverse city, and I will continue to embrace Plainfield's diversity and will make sure that everyone is respected and that we give every person the opportunity, regardless of color, regardless of creed, regardless of station in life, zip code. We are going to continue to focus on bringing Plainfield together as one Plainfield. I am someone who came from the harshest conditions, and I don't want to let anything, whether we call it race, whether we call it social or economic class, I don't want any of that to stand in the way of how our city moves forward and grows. And I reject any notion that will place labels on our city and tarnish its reputation across the state, across the country. We will continue to unify our city, bring it together, and exploit the diversity that makes us strong. And that's where I stand.
Thank you. Ms. Rivers.
I guess she's looking at my notes. No. That's one of the things that I stated also, that Plainfield is a diverse community. I come from a single-mother household where I went from that little girl to this woman. My mother taught me a lot about being able to stand up, whether you're in being uncomfortable, comfortable in an uncomfortable situation. I raised my children the same way. It does start at the household. I will continue to bring our youth to different areas. I live in the fourth ward, but I can go in any ward in the city of Plainfield. We have a beautiful community, and I will continue again. I'm going to go back to this community center. We are going to educate our youth in this community center so that they will be able to stand up to the greatest. We will be able to unify Plainfield. It's not one Plainfield, one future. It's not, because that what's left out of that one future is the fourth ward, and we have to end the first ward. And we have to find a way that we can bridge it all together. I am that candidate that will. Thank you.
Thank you. Next question. Why are we paying my tax while the builders of the new apartment buildings are paying no tax for 20 years? And Dr. Davis Ibezi is going to answer first. And the question deals with why are we paying high tax while the builders of the new apartment buildings are paying no tax for the next 20 years?
Mm. Moderator, you just asked the wrong person this very important question. I am the wrong person because I've not been in that closed room where these decisions were made. I have asked the question over and over again. What took place under the table? Otherwise, this would not be the case. The residents of Plainfield cannot be carrying the developers on their back. Developers, people who are willing to help the city of Plainfield should come here, help the city, pay taxes just like residents do. If they're not willing to pay taxes, let them not come here. We are able to attract people who will be willing to come here and make a difference in the life of their city. Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Mack.
Well, that question is built on a false premise. And here are the facts. There's a $50 million development on South Avenue. We're resigning a 30-year payment in lieu of taxes agreement. And the fact of the matter is, for the 30 years, had we done nothing at that site, we would have collected $3 million in taxes. As a result of the $50 million investment over the same 30-year period with the pilot, we are collecting $10.8 million, over $7 million more than what we would have otherwise collected. Right across the street from Reverend Brown's church, it was a vacant, blighted site owned by the city. Then we were collecting zero. As a result, we're going to be collecting $3.5 million. So the notion that these developers are paying no taxes is totally false and should not be repeated by anyone. Check the facts out. It's totally false.
Ms. Rivers, that is correct. We will be getting more tax monies from those sites. But what we failed as an administration is that we didn't educate the residents of Plainfield. They need to be educated on tax abatements. That's where we failed. But the truth be told, we will be having more money as a councilperson who voted to give an incentive to a developer. There will be more money added to our tax base where there was less before these developers went in place. Effective immediately. The monies will be added to our tax base, but we just must educate our community. That's what's missing, the education of our community. You have to invest again in your infrastructure, which is your community, to educate them on these tax abatements. And that's the only way they will know that yes, there is more monies coming into the city of Plainfield. And I commend our economic development. I commend the manager of the economic development, because you are bringing in more tax base. But
thank
what
you.
I don't like is the development that you have brought in.
Thank you, thank you. Reverend Brown.
Well, again, pilot, you know, can be very helpful incentive in helping a city to become revitalized. again, as a council person, I did vote on two of them, but I didn't mean for it to be a trend. And when you look at the impact it's going to have on our city, you know, we were not, you know, one, I think we were the first ones to, I was the first one to ever hear on the council, you know, what a pilot was. And the way it was explained, you know, by the administration was like it was just a wonderful thing for the city of Plainfield. And having done due diligence, I realized that, you know, in order to really be responsible in presenting pilots to our city, we've got to look at the sales and taxes, and we have to get the stakeholders to also come in on the discussion. The property on South Avenue, you know, it's prime real estate. You know, even though there's a pilot on, you know, I would love to see some real economic development there. I would really love to see, you know, Applebee's there, Starbucks there, instead of 200 apartment units.
As a new Plainfield resident, what is your plan for keeping young adults like myself in this city? And Mr. Mack, you get to answer this first.
I think it's important that we continue to focus on revitalizing our downtown. And that is one of the reasons why we are focused on bringing in mixed-use development. That is one of the reasons why we're focused on building a multi-tier sport facility so that people will have a place to go and enjoy wholesome recreational opportunities. There are a number of things that this administration is focused on. We want to make sure that we continue